The network view graph is a great way to visualize your network, but it's a lot more than just a pretty face. Let's talk about what's so great about the network graph. Of course, you can always zoom in and see more information around all of the assets that are in your network, but there's a lot of things that you can do from a drilling down and filtering perspective. So quick, let's take a look at what you can do with links. So let's say I want to take a look at this from a security perspective. Well, I'd go in here, click on links, click on only links with alerts. Maybe I want to trigger a specific type of alert. Let's say I want to look for packet rules, or, you know, you can see a lot of options from the drop down here. But let's just take a look at the packet rules. So let's click on that, select only links with alerts, and apply. And there we go. So we can very quickly drill down to the links in my network that are having issues. Then, of course, it's an easy matter to just go in and click on these links and get more information around them. You can see here as we drill in that this particular link has three packet rules that have been triggered, and one of them actually being a Dragonfly 2 detection. So definitely an easy way to get in really quickly and see where there are security events in your network. Of course, the graph isn't just for network security issues. You can also do a lot of troubleshooting. Let's say you've got devices in your network that are having connectivity issues. Well, from here you can actually go in, click on these links, go to Perspective TCP Retransmitted Bytes, and hit apply. And now we're going to start seeing how many of these links are showing up with retransmitted bytes. And in fact, you see a lot of them are green, and it's, you know, seems pretty okay. But let's go over here to this filter and say, let's just show me the ones with very high retransmission rates. And click on that, and you can see very quickly the ones that are highlighted right there. So these are the issues that you need to start focusing on in your network. It's real easy to feel overwhelmed when you deploy Nozomi due to all of the information that's collecting on your network. So we've actually collected a number of kind of quality of life filters that you can deploy really quickly from this magic wand here. You can see a number of quality of life things you can quickly select here. You can hide all broadcast traffic just to clean things up a bit. You can also decide to only show links and nodes with confirmed data. These things will really quickly clean up the view and allow you to have a much cleaner interface to deal with. Of course, you can also use this to really filter very quickly on specific types of network traffic. So let's say you only want to see protocols, say for example HTTP and maybe HTTPS, and where those are floating around in your network. You can click on that and very quickly just see where that type of traffic exists in your network. This is a really good way to see, you know, the specific types of information and traffic that's going along and really help you pinpoint on certain problem areas in your network. So really, let's think of the graph as not necessarily just a pretty bird's eye view of your network, but also of a very powerful tool for troubleshooting network issues, as well as very quickly pinpointing any security problems that you might have floating around. So that's just a quick overview of what's so cool about the graph. If you'd like more information, please check out our website at www.nozominetworks.com. Thank you.